A recent report from Hunger Free America shows more than 1 in 4 Bronx residents experience food insecurity.
With food costs in New York City among the highest in the country, many families are forced to choose between buying groceries or paying rent, or in Chevelle Mendoza's case, paying tuition.
Authorities believe this pair seen on video is behind a number of robberies taking place in the Grand Concourse and Morrisania neighborhood. Gianna, police say at least 10 people were shot last night through the evening. Now, police are not commenting on a motive for any of these cases, but it's sure to leave these communities on edge during the holidays.
Hundreds gathered together at Kelch Park on Saturday to march with a message for city officials. The Bronx Coalition for a Community Vision protested the city's rezoning plans for Jerome Avenue.
The plans that they have presented so far shows that there's going to be massive displacement of tenants. There's going to be massive loss of small businesses.
Future of the auto industry on Jerome Avenue is now a mystery after the rezoning of the area was approved last week by city council.
And if you drive down Jerome Avenue, a large portion of this is made up by auto shops. Now, they say many of the workers and the owners here say they feel pushed out by the city council and pushed out by the city.
So what's going to happen? They're all going to be out of business, and they're all going to have without a job. They're going to be without a job. Inevitably, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of mechanics are going to be out of a job. That's no question about it. If they don't do something about it,